everybody. I hope everyone is doing well today. And I just want to mention before we get into this video, if you have watched my previous videos about creating the urn DIY for my precious pet Leela, I'd like to report that I have placed her ashes inside the urn and put the collar around the top, and she is now placed on top of the altar mantle exactly where she belongs, and it's just really wonderful. That's exactly where she needed to be. So I'm really happy with how that turned out. And if you haven't watched those videos, then I would love it if you do. So please be sure to check those last two videos out. It's a two-part video series, by the way. Not really a series, but two-part video. Anyhow, today's video is going to be a part of my meditative, intuitive series. I wanted to share with you today something that I have put together to take with me whenever Jimmy and I travel. And when I say travel, I don't necessarily mean on day trips and things like that. Although, come to think of it, this could be a great thing to put together for day trips as well, particularly if you're going to have a picnic or you're going out into the woods and you'll be spreading a blanket and just enjoying nature in general. So this could be a wonderful way to honor yourself and the idea of those types of day trips. But in particularly the traveling times that I'm speaking of is when you actually travel to a different place where you're going to be staying for a few days. So keep that in mind, but again, you could use this for specific day trips. So I'm having a sip of coffee. It's so good. but let me show you what I'm talking about. This is my traveling altar. And I put this together in a beautiful box that I had, and I tied it all together with a ribbon just to keep it closed. And I'm going to take the ribbon off and show you what I have inside it. Now, these are just a few items that I have placed inside this box, and I haven't looked at it in quite a while, so there is a possibility that I might want to update it if I decide to take it with me somewhere soon. But this is what was in the box from the times that we have traveled. And I also enclosed a beautiful picture of a Lily of the Valley plant, because Lily of the Valley is the symbolic flower for the month of May. And my birthday is in May. I am a Taurus, and that is my flower, the beautiful Lily of the Valley. So I just thought that it would be perfect to have it here as kind of a representation of me. And, oh, there was Jimmy. Hi, Jimmy. I thought I heard somebody come in here. But anyways, it's a representation of me. So you could actually take a box and you could find out what your monthly flower is, if you don't already know. And if you do know, wonderful. And go ahead and print it out on your printer. And you could decoupage it to a box. Or if you happen to have a box like this, that's almost like a picture frame, you could do it just like this. But anyhow, inside the box is, and I'm going to try to tilt it so you can, I hope you can see that, so nothing seems to fall out of it, just to share with you what I have in here. And so let me go through and tell you exactly what I have in here. So I have just a few things that makes it just a small traveling altar at the moment. And looking at it now, I would add a few other things, and I'll get to that in a moment. But what is inside here currently is I have a doily to place down as a altar cloth-like item. And then I have a little base to hold my candle or candles. And in this case, I have several tea lights. I currently have four inside the box, but you could put whatever fits. So I have just basic tea lights inside here, and these have been cleansed and prepared and ready for burning of the sacred space that you are trying to cleanse and bring good energy into while you are away. And of course, having candles, I also have a pack of matches because you would need that in case there's no matches around where you're at. But I would say if you're going to a picnic type setting or a forest type of setting, to be very, very careful with lighting your candles and also extinguishing your candles. You don't want to create any forest fires and be responsible for that. Nor do I want to be responsible, and I am not responsible for any irresponsibility that you might have in burning your candles. So I just needed to put that little disclaimer out there, but I think you all get the picture. In addition, I have some herbs in this little bag, and what's inside here are basically herbs for love and protection. So I have some salt, some sea salt, I have some rose petals and rose buds, and I have sage. So what I would add to this box, if I were going to be updating it currently, is I would probably add a few crystals. If I were going to be traveling for the day or the week or however length of time, I would think about what it is that I was feeling at the time of preparing for the outing, and also for what it was that I wanted to bring to me into my sacred space that I was creating wherever I may be. And so I would choose a crystal to kind of coordinate with that. And the best crystals that you could do, just right off the top of my head, that would be wonderful to take, would be, of course, rose quartz. You could take some amethyst. You could take some selenite, you know, things like that that most people have in their collection. Or clear quartz. Clear quartz is the perfect stone for any time. So those are the things that you could take with you. And that is just an idea that you could use for your meditative sacred spaces and have a little traveling altar wherever you may go. So I hope that this has inspired you to create something of your own. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. And I would love to see a video response of what you have come to put together for your traveling altar. And yes, please feel free to share that with me. So I hope you're having a wonderful and magical day. Thank you so much for being with me and watching this video. And I wish you many blessings, peace, joy, and many friendships to come. And I will see you in my next video. Until then, bye.